got you laughing, I'm happy.
Happy.
Every time I hear that song, there's only one gal I can hear doing it. Mary May Harrell. You remember her?
Sure you do.
Some performer, some kid, some heart. I always had a lot of faith in her from the very beginning. But fate is funny, you know. It never really works out the way you hope it would. I remember the whole story like it was yesterday. Mary May was born to sing.
Let me sing a funny song, pretty words that roll along. And if my song can start you laughing, I'm happy, happy.
Well, the little girl grew up. Boy, did she ever.
Let me tune a low-down blues to lift you out of your seat. And if my song can reach your shoes and start you tapping your feet, I'm happy.
What's the Massachusetts? They knew better. It was only a matter of time before they lost Mary May to the world. And the day she graduated high school, she joined a variety show heading for Hollywood. Naturally, I followed her. Hey, a kid like that alone in that city? You know what I mean? I became her manager. I mean, who knows her better than me, right? The first night we arrived, I even get her invited to this big Hollywood bash. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you the toast of Europe, Mary May Harrell.
I like that girl. Sign her quick. Fantastic. Well, Mary May was signed all right, and she started working at Miracle Pictures the next day, but not exactly in the capacity she dreamed about.
Just his mannequin. It's not really George Lord. It is George Lord.
I've been noticing you.
Me?
Yes, you.
That smile.
Isn't it romantic? Music in the night, a dream that can be heard. Isn't it romantic? Moving shadows like the oldest magic word. You know this, don't you?
George Lord and Mary May Harold. They became inseparable. The two, the only. George demanded that L.B. Mandera put her in his next big musical, Mississippi Paradise. So the ball began to roll. Movie after movie, song after song, hit after hit. Hollywood was happy for the couple. Everyone except L.B. Mandero.
I hate when he kisses her.
Finally, he couldn't take it anymore. And he appeared on the set right after a day of shooting. Oh, it was horrible. First, he tells her how much he loves her. I love you. I love you. And she tells him that she loves him, too. Then she realizes what he means. And she says she'll always be grateful to him, but she still loves George. I love George. I love George. Well, this was not what LB wanted to hear. And then he said, I can't take it anymore. And he tried to make a pass. She rebuked him. You're an animal, she said. Well, he couldn't control himself, and he slapped her. Then he said he'd finish her in this town, and Mary May was determined to make it without LB. That LB had put the wheels of her destruction into motion, using the most powerful weapon known to Hollywood, gossip. Well, it was effective. Writers wouldn't write for her. Composers wouldn't compose for her. And agents wouldn't agent for her. Even George Lord was confused. But then I got this great idea. From all my years of handling her and managing her, I'd saved quite a bundle. So I thought, why not open our own club? And I had the perfect name for it. Ladies and gentlemen, the Key Change is proud to present the first time on any supper club stage, Mary May Harold.
Let me sing a funny song. With crazy words that roll along. And if my song can start you laughing, I'm happy, happy. Let me sing a sad refrain of broken hearts that loved in vain. And if my song can start you crying, I'm happy.
It was you. It was always you.
You know that. You have to.
Get over here, you big lug.